एनवायरमेंटल फंक्शन असेसमेंट. सो वील फॉर्मली स्टार्ट आवर एग्जामिनेशन क्लास अ फ्यू मिनट्स लेटर. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर द कैमरा. सो दिस क्लास वुड नॉट बी पॉसिबल विदाउट वीडियो. अच्छा, टिल देन सिंस दिस इज थर्ड ईयर्स, सो anyone, I can see there are 126 participants here. So what do you understand by higher mental functions? Anyone, you can answer by chat, preferably by chat. So till we are waiting for the camera to formally start, anyone of you can tell me, okay, what do you mean by higher mental functions? Or mujhe ye bhi bata do bachcho, can you people hear me? Is it loud enough? अच्छा जी, somebody raised a hand, so who is it? What do you, my question is, what do you understand by higher mental functions? We can hear you. Okay, thinking and cognition, Minha. ठीक है, थिंकिंग एंड कॉग्निशन. व्हाट एल्स? प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग, गुड. यूज ऑफ लैंग्वेज, मेमोरी, इमोशंस एंड परसेप्शंस. ओके, ठीक है. और व्हाट एल्स? एनीथिंग एल्स? अटेंशन एंड व्हाट एल्स? स्पीच, लर्निंग, ठीक है. हायर मेंटल फंक्शन, ठीक है. इट हैज टू डू समथिंग विद द हायर फंक्शंस ऑफ द ब्रेन. ओके, फाइन. सो हाउ वुड वी असेस, लाइक व्हाट क्वेश्चंस वुड यू आस्क, और हाउ वुड यू एग्जामिन द हायर मेंटल फंक्शन? हाउ वुड यू असेस व्हाट क्वेश्चंस? लाइक सपोज लेट्स स्टार्ट, वी आर एग्जामिनिंग अ पेशेंट हु इज 10 इयर्स ओल्ड. अब ये जो सारी बातें आपने मुझे बताई हैं, हाउ वुड यू असेस हायर मेंटल फंक्शंस ऑफ दैट पेशेंट, अ 10 ईयर ओल्ड चाइल्ड कमिंग टू योर ओपीडी, एंड व्हाट क्वेश्चन वुड यू आस्क? हाँ, दे दीजिए. Anyone? What question would you ask? How would you assess higher mental function? ये जो सारी बातें बताई हैं, how would you check them in the patient? So we got the camera. Now I'm sharing the video. Okay. ठीक है. Thank you. Advising the child to follow certain commands, ठीक है. Area he lived, whether the child can understand your questions, show pictures of objects and ask what are those, ठीक है. चलो, that means it doesn't seem like third year students. You people already know so many things. So the higher mental functions, we have to follow a strict upset pattern if we are assessing a child who is older enough, who's cooperative enough, and who can understand you. So we start with the parents of the child. We'll see whether the child is welcomed or not. The parents complements the age of the child. Like, what would we expect from the parents of a 10-year-old child? We would expect that the child is dressed properly, has combed the hairs. We'll see the hygiene of that patient. ठीक है, तो दैट दीज ऑल थिंग्स कम इन द अपीयरेंस. देन वी चेक द लेवल ऑफ द अलर्टनेस, कि इज द चाइल्ड अलर्ट, इज द चाइल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिव, इज द चाइल्ड आंसरिंग योर सिंपल क्वेश्चंस, इज द चाइल्ड फॉलोइंग द कमांड्स. अच्छा, नाउ दिस लेवल ऑफ अलर्टनेस डिफर्स फ्रॉम एज टू एज. लाइक द लेवल ऑफ अलर्टनेस वुड बी डिफरेंट फॉर अ टॉडलर एंड इट वुड बी डिफरेंट फॉर अ ओल्डर चाइल्ड. ठीक है, अ 2 ईयर ओल्ड चाइल्ड मे नॉट बी एज अलर्ट और एज रिस्पॉन्सिव टू यू एज अ 10 ईयर ओल्ड चाइल्ड. देन वी असेस द स्पीच ऑफ द चाइल्ड एंड लेटर ऑन वी विल जस्ट क्विकली गो थ्रू सम स्पीच डिसऑर्डर्स. वील सी कि वेदर द स्पीच इज एज अप्रोप्रिएट. लाइक फॉर अ 10 ईयर ओल्ड फॉर अ 2 ईयर ओल्ड चाइल्ड ही और शी मे ओनली बी एबल टू स्पीक स्पीक टू वर्ड और 3 वर्ड सेंटेंसेस. ठीक है, बट फॉर 8 ईयर्स और 10 ईयर और अ स्कूल गोइंग चाइल्ड द चाइल्ड शुड स्पीच वॉट एवर देयर नेटिव लैंग्वेजेस एंड समटाइम्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन देयर अपब्रिंगिंग दे कैन दे मे बी एबल टू स्पीक मोर देन वन लैंग्वेजेस. ठीक है, लाइक इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इन आर सेटअप द पेशेंट मे नो पेशेंट शुड स्पीक उर्दू एंड इफ दे बिलोंग टू certain other ethnicities, their other languages, like some know Sindhi, some know Pashto, and sometimes since English is considered a international language, so most of the children at that age should be able to understand that. So it depends upon the age of the child. Then the behavior of the child, is it age appropriate? Is it appropriate according to the environment? The behavior of a child depends upon so the assessment of behavior, that also is the responsibility of the brain, higher mental functions of the brain. And then awareness of the environment, jisko hum bahut commonly kehte hain ki orientation of the child. Now this orientation can be in different points, it can be in with time, place and person. Theek hai? Or the patient should know whom the child is talking to you, where the child is present, whether the child is in the hospital, in the clinic, at home, or certain other places, or with whom the child is interacting. Now, all this orientation can be assessed easily in an older child as compared to a younger child. Because a smaller child obviously would not be able to tell that the child is in a hospital setup. Then orientation with the time, that you can check that this thing by asking the patient what time is it? Is it morning time or evening time? So if they are answering all these things correctly, that means the child is oriented. Like we usually start our examination with this statement that my patient is a young boy of average built-in height, sitting comfortably on bed, oriented with time, place of the person. So this orientation is the prime function of prime assessment of higher mental functions. Then somebody rightly said the thought process and content, whatever they are thinking, whatever a person is thinking at the moment, and what is their thought process. This is also considered as higher mental functions. Then memory, it can be immediate recall, recent or remote. All these functions are the responsibility of the brain and are included in higher mental functions. And sometimes it's age appropriate, their ability to perform simple calculations. Okay, the simple calculations would be different again according to the age, would be different for a 2 years old. Oh, 2 years old can't calculate, obviously, but would be different for a 6 or 7 year old, would be different for a 10 years old, and would be different for an adolescent child. Then judgment. How do you assess their judgment? You give them a scenarios. This I'm talking about older children. You can't assess the judgment in very smaller children. Obviously, they don't have developed that ability to differentiate between different scenarios. So you give common scenarios to the patients and ask them, okay, how would they assess? Like you ask them, okay, what would they do if they are in a building and the fire has erupted, what would be their immediate reaction? This is how you assess their judgment. And then higher cortical functioning and reasoning to different problems. How time, place and person, I abhi to bataya hai bache ki how do we assess? We ask the patient ki what time of the day it is. Okay, if the patient is rightly telling the time, okay, it's a daytime or a night time or evening time, that is orientation with time. Orientation with person is you ask ke, who's accompanying the patient. If the patient is able to recognize the person who is coming with the patient in the OPD, that means the patient patient is oriented with the person, or you can ask pointing towards yourself, ki who am I, you, what do you think, who am I? So obviously the answer would be, I'm talking to a doctor. So that is orientation with the person. And place, ki where are you at the moment? Theek hai? This is orientation with time, place and person. Now we had skipped some speech. So speech assessment of a speech, we have to ask them few questions, and we'll, by their response to the to those questions, we'll assess their speech. Now there are three basic disorders of the speech, that are dysarthria, dysphonia and dysphasia. Dysarthria is happens due to damage to those parts of the nervous system that regulate the action of voice and speech. And if there is damage to that, then it will cause alterations in the speech pattern. The most important disorder causing the dysarthria is the cerebral palsy. What is cerebral palsy? Any damage to the brain, to the growing brain, which if it is done in that part of the brain which is responsible for speech production, so that will cause dysarthria in the patient. Again, dysarthria can be caused by local lesions of the tongue. Dysarthria is basically the articulation problem. Theek hai? Any lesion in the tongue, the patient would not be able to speak properly. Any lesion in the lip or mouth, sometimes if we have aphthous ulcer, a very deep aphthous ulcer, we are not able to speak properly. So that is dysarthria, but that is temporarily. The dysarthria that is in the cerebral palsy, that is type of permanent one. Then again, bulbar palsy and pseudobulbar palsy, isme kya hota hai? 9th and 10th nerves, abhi hum aage karenge. Palsies hoti hain, the muscles of the pharynx are not working properly, so there will be articulation problem. So any problem, any damage that is causing alteration in articulation of the child, it is called dysarthria. Then there is dysphonia. Dysphonia kya hota hai? Disorders of the voice. Okay. Disorders of the voice are described as dysphonia. It usually result from vocal cord pathology. Okay. Vocal cord mein pathology hogi or damage to the vagal nerve which is supplying the vocal cords. So there will be different nasal twang to the voice. There will be you can't see the slides. Which slide you people are seeing? जब नहीं दिखे ना तो जस्ट प्रॉम्प्ट मी. चलो तो dysarthria वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, इट इज आर्टिकुलेशन प्रॉब्लम. द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज इज सेरेब्रल पैल्सी एंड देर कैन बी लोकल पैथोलॉजीज एज वेल विच कॉजेस विच कैन बी एनी प्रॉब्लम इन द लिप, माउथ और टंग. ठीक है. सेकेंड वन इज द डिस्फोनिया, डिसऑर्डर्स ऑफ द वॉइस. We all know that the voice is produced by passage of air through the vocal cord. So any damage to the vocal cord directly, either due to any outgrowth or due to the nerve supplying the vocal cords, it is called dysphonia. Production of voice mein problem hai. Articulation problem nahi hai. Us waqt kya tha? Articulation problem thi. Ya to brain ka problem tha, brain centers ka problem tha, ya articulation problem thi. What happens in dysphonia? Okay, disorders of this is a disorder of the voice. Or sometimes dysphonia can be due to vagal nerve damage. Then comes dysphasia. Dysphasia means a partial or total loss of language as a result of lesion in those parts of the brain that are directly linked to the language function. Ab wo kaun se parts hote hain brain ke? Go back to your physiology. There are two main areas of the brain. Broca's area, isko hum kehte hain anterior speech area, and Wernicke's area. This is called posterior speech area. Broca's hota hai anterior to the central convolution in the frontal lobe, or Wernicke's hota hai in the temporal, in the parietal lobe mein. अब इनका फंक्शन क्या होता है विल सी यार. दीज आर द टू मेन पार्ट्स ऑफ द ब्रेन दैट आर डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू लैंग्वेज फंक्शन. ये हमने बता दिया. ब्रोकास इन द थर्ड फ्रंटल कॉन्वोल्यूशन में होता है एंड वर्निकीज इन द पोस्टीरियर थर्ड ऑफ द अपर टेम्पोरल कॉन्वोल्यूशंस. नाउ दिस ब्रोकास एरिया इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर वर्ड प्रोडक्शन एंड लैंग्वेज एक्सप्रेशन. Whereas Wernicke's area comprehends the spoken language. Okay, Wernicke is usually sometimes what happens if Broca's area is damaged, so the patient may be able to understand whatever is said to the patient, but not able to speak. Like if you ask the patient's name, the patient may not be able to tell the name if the Broca's area is damaged. But if you ask, if you say that patient to close the eye, the patient may be able to close the eye. That means comprehension is intact, but word production is impaired. Again, if Wernicke's is affected, damage aisa hua hai ki Wernicke's area is involved. So in that case, what will happen? The patient may speak small sentences or one or two word sentences, but the patient may not be able to understand. Kyunki comprehension wala area is affected. So this was a just quick overview of speech disorder. Later on you will do it in some other. Now we'll start our main topic, that is the cranial nerve infection examination. So before starting, can anyone please tell me how many cranial nerves are there in total and what are the basic types of the cranial nerves? Twelve. There are 12 altogether. And what are the types of sensory and motor? ठीक है. Or some are mixed also. ठीक है. Sensory, motor and mixed. Very good. So starting with the cranial nerve one. अच्छा, before starting it, this is just an effort to make you people understand the examination. However, complete learning of the examination is not possible through distance learning. ठीक है. Until unless you do it on the patient or we explain to you, it to you on the patient, we won't be able to tell you. For assistance, you may see so many, there are so many videos available with the heading of cranial nerves examination on YouTube. You can go through them, you can read it in your examination books, but until unless you do it on the patient, you won't be able to remember it correctly. But the good thing is that the condition is improving and very soon you will be joining your wards, so then definitely we'll be arranging classes on patients. Okay, so hope for the best. This is just an effort to make you people familiar with the examination. Okay, this cannot be the alternative of an examination on a real patient. So starting with the cranial nerve one. Achha, one more thing, in pediatric age group, so many examinations, they are age dependent, like so many, and especially when it comes to the CNS examination, you have to skip so many of the CNS examination if the kid is very smaller, because obviously the CNS examination needs cooperation of the patient. If the patient is very small and not cooperative, you won't be able to do it. So we presume that whatever we are doing it on older patients. Now starting with the cranial nerve one, it is called the olfactory nerve. It is basically, the main function of this nerve is the sense of smell. How do you detect it? Either patient khud hi aapko aake bata dega, zyada bada patient hota hai ki doctor abhi I'm not able to smell anything, or abhi recently this has been seen very commonly in COVID patients. How would you test it? You will test it with the eyes closed. Okay, we check both each nostril separately and we take some non-pungent smells, familiar smells like orange peels, coffee powder, some common soaps, toothpastes. Ask the patient to close the eyes and block one nostril, put something in front of the another nostril, ask the patient to inhale, smell and tell whether the patient is able to identify the smell or not. And again, you'll repeat it from both the nostrils. And the patient can tell it correctly, that means the olfaction is intact. The cranial nerve one is intact. So this is easiest and the simplest method to check. There are so many conditions in which the olfaction is impaired. COVID, close head injuries, any damage to the olfactory areas of the brain, and so on. Now, this is the method. But isme aankhein khuli hui hain, but you ask the as a patient to smell it with closed eyes, or if you are using the essence of something directly, wo object we use kar rahe, like in this picture the patient is inhaling the essence. So in that case obviously the patient can keep the eye open, but if you are bringing in light as in moving, why does it happen to me always? अब मूव कर रही है बच्चों, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट इज ऑप्टिक नर्व दिख रहा है अभी, यस ओके. चलो ऑप्टिक नर्व में क्या होता है, द मेन फंक्शन इज विजन. But components of examination क्या होते हैं? We have to check the visual acuity, we have to check the field of the vision, we have to check them for color vision, and we have to do the fundus examination. And the fundus examination के लिए we need to have ophthalmoscope, and that can only be taught on real patients. वो मैं अभी नहीं बता सकती. Fundoscope से आप patient का eyes dilate करके behind the eyes retina check करते हैं. Then visual acuity कैसे चेक करते हैं? Now there are different methods of checking visual acuity in different age groups. For infants, you will just observe them. Obviously, you can't assess it through any charts. छोटा बच्चा है, infant है, वो तो कुछ भी नहीं करेगा. So you just have to rely on observation. Give whether the infant is reaching towards the objects of varying sizes. उसके सामने आप colorful objects रख दोगे and you'll see कि whether the child is reaching for that object or not. More than 6 months, बच्चों में pincer grafts आ जाते हैं 6 to 9 months में, तो you'll observe them for reaching for scraps or tiny tiny things like less than 5 millimeter. It can be resins, it can be beads placed on a dark background, some black thing, some beads, some scraps of paper, and you'll see if the patient is reaching for that or not. Older children may we do it through a standard recognition of letters, numbers or shapes on a Snellen chart. जो के सपने ही ऑलमोस्ट देखे होंगे. वी कीप द पेशेंट ऑन अ डिस्टेंस, आस्क द पेशेंट टू सिट ऑन अ स्पेसिफाइड डिस्टेंस एंड आस्क देम टू रीड इट. अच्छा, दिस इज द स्टैंडर्ड चार्ट, बट इफ द पेशेंट इज नॉट एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज द लेटर्स, सो वी हैव द चार्ट विद दीज पिक्चर्स, बिकॉज नॉट इंग्लिश इज नॉट एवरीबडीज लैंग्वेज. ठीक है, सो वी कैन ऑल्सो use this type of pictorial charts. इसको हम कहते हैं Snellen chart. Then visual field. We introduce objects into the peripheral field of vision as the child focuses on an object held directly in front of them. We ask the patient to look straight. ठीक है, stabilize the head and all the peripheries. से we move some object from all the peripheries in both the areas, and we check it by, we say it, we are checking it by confrontation method. Visual field, we are checking it through confrontation visual field test. Examiner sits 1 meter away from the patient whose right eye is tested with the examiner's left eye. Like if like suppose you are the patient sitting in front of me and we both are sitting at 1 meter distance. So if I am checking your right eye, so I'll close my left eye. Okay, your right eye would be at my left. So by doing this, we should have, considering that we both have perfect vision, we should have equal visibility in our visual field. So opposite eyes should be closed. If it's patient's right eye is closed, so examiner's left eye would be closed. Now we introduce different number of fingers or a sharp object or colorful object from all the peripheries. Like if I am closing my left eye, patient is closing the right eye, so I will introduce any colored object, like my finger, like I'll introduce 2 fingers from all the peripheries, and we लाइक दिस, ऊपर से भी ठीक है, देन फ्रॉम ऑल द फोर क्वाड्रेंट्स. सो बोथ द एग्जामिनर एंड वील आस्क द पेशेंट टू प्रॉम्प्ट द एग्जामिनर व्हेन द when the patient starts seeing the finger or colored object or whatever thing is used, or if we are using the finger, we ask the patient to mimic the number of fingers. We can do it either ways. Ideally, it should be simultaneous for both the patient and the doctor. This is called confrontation visual field. Proper visual field is testing is done through perimetry. That is an instrument. ठीक है, वो आपको आए वाले पढ़ाएंगे. But this is confrontation visual field. This is how we do it. ठीक है, this is how we do it. The doctor or the examiner is introducing finger from all the quadrants. Then we check the pupillary reflexes. To best see this, the room should be dimly lit. ठीक है ना, वरना आपको construction और light का effect पता नहीं चलेगा. Now there are two type of pupillary reflexes, direct pupillary reflex and indirect pupillary reflex. Any for any reflex, there has to be an afferent component and efferent component. Afferent for is that one which carries images from periphery to the CNS, and efferent bring back the orders from the brain. So for pupillary reflex mein jo afferent hota hai, that is through the cranial nerve 2 jo bhi hum kar rahe hain, aur efferent through the cranial nerve 3. So any if any of the nerve is involved, so pupillary reflex would be affected. What we do to check the pupillary reflex, we shine a light into the pupil. First we block it, ठीक है, ताकि दूसरी आई में ना जाए. Shine a light from the side and we see the size of the pupil. So what will happen? कि as we shine the light, the pupil will constrict. So now the afferent would be through the cranial nerve 2. Efferent would be through the cranial nerve 3. Sluggish reaction hai, ye lack of constriction may suggest pathology in the optic nerve, in brainstem, or sometimes due to any drugs. Then there is another type of reflex that is called consensual pupillary reflex. Usme aap kya karte ho? Again, you block this one, you shine the light in one eye, and you check the constriction in opposite one. ठीक है, got it. This is called consensual pupillary reflex. If we are shining the light in one eye, तो one eye that pupil should constrict, but along with that, the opposite contralateral pupil should also constrict. So this is called consensual light reflex. क्यों? क्योंकि it has dual nerve supply. Then one more function of eye is accommodation reflex. Accommodation reflex kya hota hai ki when we are seeing at a distant object and then suddenly we have to look at a nearer object, so to accommodate that, the lens, the both the eyes lens converge and the pupil constricts. So what we do, we ask the patient to look at the wall and suddenly ask them at your finger. That is put close to the nose of the patient. Look there and again look here. So you will see the both the eyes constrict and converge in order to accommodate the image. Okay, this is how you do it. You keep the finger in front of the patient's nose, ask them to look at the wall or at some hanging, and then again ask them to look at your finger. The last one is the color vision. We check basically for three primary colors, that is red, green, blue, by showing different color twice. Ishiara eye plates are used in older children, and usually we ask the child to identify the number produced by different colors. So this, it looks like this. The Ishiara charts look like this. ठीक है, and we ask the patient if they are able to recognize the numbers written on these Ishiara charts or not. So these color plates are already available. Then first हो गई, second हो गई, then third, fourth and sixth. These nerves are checked simultaneously. क्यों? Because these nerves supply the all the extra ocular muscles of the eye. Eye के सारे muscles को ये supply करती हैं. The function is basic function is to move to cause the eye movements. ठीक है, एंड इफ एनी डैमेज टू एनी ऑफ थर्ड फोर्थ और सिक्स, यहाँ पे अभी हमने फिफ्थ स्किप की है, विल डू इट लेटर. इफ एनी नर्व इज डैमेज, तो द मोस्ट कॉमन प्रॉब्लम दैट द पेशेंट विल हैव इज डिप्लोपिया, दैट इज डुअल विजन. वी मूव द आईज इन आस चेक इट बाय मूविंग द आई इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन ऑफ द विजुअल फील्ड, एंड यूजली इट इज इट कैन बी डन अबव द एज ऑफ 4 years, बिकॉज अगेन स्मॉलर चिल्ड्रन विल नॉट कोऑपरेट. यूजली छोटे बच्चों में वी यूज डॉल्स आई मूवमेंट फिनोमिना, बट दैट इज नॉट कॉमनली डन. एंड डॉल्स, वॉट इज डॉल्स आई फिनोमिना, दैट इज योर होमवर्क. यू विल योर सेल्फ फाइंड इट आउट कि वॉट इज डॉल्स आई फिनोमिना. नाउ the third, fourth and sixth nerve, so the basic function is to supply the extraocular muscles of the eye. Now the question is, how many extraocular muscles of the eye are there? So there are 4 recti: superior rectus, inferior rectus, lateral rectus, medial rectus, and 2 obliques: superior oblique and inferior oblique. So recti usually they work whatever they name in that direction. The superior rectus will move the eye up, inferior rectus will move the eye down, medial will move medially, lateral will move laterally. Or bulky oblique muscles, they function opposite their names. Like superior oblique will move the eyeball downward, inferior oblique will move the eyeball upward. So the recti move the eyes in their own direction, obliques move the eye in opposite direction. So this is something. Okay, superior rectus looks laterally and upward. Inferior rectus looks laterally, like looks laterally and downwards. Matlab when the eye is moved laterally, then in that position it will move up and down. ठीक है, लेटरल रेक्टस मूव द आई लेटरली, मीडियल रेक्टस मीडियली, इनफीरियर ऑब्लिक व्हेन द आई इज इन द मीडियल पोजीशन तो वो इट विल मूव अपवर्ड. सुपीरियर ऑब्लिक इन द मीडियल पोजीशन ऑफ, आई की दो पोजीशन हो सकते हैं, मीडियल एंड लेटरल. तो मीडियल पोजीशन में अपवर्ड मूव करेगा इनफीरियर ऑब्लिक, डाउनवर्ड मूव करेगा सुपीरियर ऑब्लिक. अच्छा, हाउ वुड यू टेस्ट इट? ट्राइजेमिनल से पहले, फिफ्थ से पहले हम थर्ड फोर्थ एंड सिक्स कर लेते हैं. तो वी मूव इन स्टेबलाइज द हेड, मूव कीप अ फिंगर इन फ्रंट ऑफ द पेशेंट्स आई एंड मूव इट इन ऑल द डायरेक्शंस. ठीक है, वी मूव इट लेटरली. व्हेन वी आर मूविंग इट अप, दैट मींस वी आर चेकिंग सुपीरियर रेक्टस ऑफ दिस आई एंड इनफीरियर ऑब्लिक ऑफ दिस आई, क्योंकि हमने कहा था मीडियल में इनफीरियर ऑब्लिक ऊपर मूव करेगा. वी विल मूव इट डाउन मीडियल रेक्टस, इनफीरियर रेक्टस. We are bringing it again to the neutral position. Lateral move kiya, to lateral rectus. Medial side ne move kiya, medial rectus. Then again, superior rectus, inferior rectus. And then we check it diagonally for any hidden squints. So we basically move it in H-shaped. All the muscles are checked. And then we move from diagonally to check any hidden squint. So in that, if the eyeball is deviating towards a specific position, so that means it that muscle is impaired, that muscle is damaged, or that nerve is damaged. Then fifth humne skip ki thi. Acha, abhi tak jo humne sari nerves ki hain, third, fourth and sixth, they were primarily motor nerves. Olfaction wali, it was sensory nerve. Now this trigeminal is the mixed form of the nerve. Iska function, main function kya hai? It is sensory to face and eyes and motor to the muscles of mastication. When we chew, the muscles of mastication are used. And again, corneal and conjunctival reflexes are again one of the functions. How do we assess their sensory function? Test sensation over forehead, cheeks and chin. 3 divisions hoti hain. Ophthalmic, if we draw a line from tegus to the outer canthus of the eye, iska above wala is the ophthalmic division. Theek hai, from here to here, it is maxillary. Theek hai, and below that it is mandibular. So all the sensations from the face, it is carried through trigeminal nerve. Then comes the motor component. Motor component mein muscles of mastication ko supply karti hai. Like we ask the patient, how will we check? We ask the patient to clench the teeth. And we'll palpate over the cheek and temple. You can check it on yourselves as well. Okay, you will feel contraction of the muscles. ठीक है, तो टेम्पोरालिस इधर होता है, टेम्पोरालिस की कॉन्ट्रैक्शन बाय क्लेंचिंग ऑफ द टीथ एंड मैसेटर्स की कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. वी आस्क द पेशेंट टू ओपन द माउथ वाइड एंड जॉ डेविएट्स टू द पैरालाइज साइड टेरिगोइड मसल्स. जो सही जो सी साइड डैमेज होगी वहां पे मूव कर जाएगा मसल जॉ. दिस इज हाउ टू चेक कॉर्नियल एंड कंजंक्टिवल रिफ्लेक्स. वी टच इट थ्रू अ स्वाब. कॉर्निया को वी अवॉइड टचिंग ड्यू टू सम इफ वी कैन कॉज एब्रेशंस और देयर वी टच द कॉर्निया एंड देयर विल बी ब्लिंकिंग. दिस इज द हाउ वी चेक सेंसेशन. दिस इज ऑप्थेल्मिक डिविजन, दिस इज मैक्सिलरी डिविजन एंड दिस इज मैंडिबुलर डिविजन. यू आस्क द पेशेंट टू क्लोज द आईज, टच इट एंड इफ द पेशेंट जस्ट फील्स द टच द पेशेंट यस और एनीथिंग we can ask them. Then this is how we check temporalis contraction. Ask the patient to clench. This is how we check masseter contraction. Then six humne kar li thi. This is the seventh nerve. Seventh nerve is facial nerve. Now facial nerve ka main function kya hota hai? Motor to the facial muscles, facial expression muscles. Abhi jo pichli wali thi usne फेशियल मसल देवर नॉट द फेशियल मसल दैट वॉज सेंसरी टू द फेशियल मसल. ठीक है, दिस इज मोटर टू द फेशियल नर्व. इट कैरीज फेशियल नर्व ऑल्सो कैरीज टेस्ट सेंसेशन फ्रॉम इंटीरियर टू थर्ड ऑफ द टंग. मोटर कैसे असिस्ट करेंगे? वी विल गिव डिफरेंट कमांड टू द पेशेंट एंड विल चेक द मसल्स ऑफ फेशियल एक्सप्रेशन. वी आस्क देम टू रेज द आईब्रोज. हाउ वुड वी डू दैट? वील आस्क देम स्टेबलाइज देयर हेड, आस्क देम टू लुक एट द सीलिंग. व्हेन दे ट्राई टू लिक देयर विल बी रिंकलिंग ऑफ द फोरहेड. ये आपने फ्रंटालिस मसल चेक कर लिया. देन वी ट्राई टू ओपन द टाइटली क्लोज आईज. वी आस्क द पेशेंट टू क्लोज द आईज टाइटली, एज क्लोज एज टाइटली एज पॉसिबल एंड वी ट्राई टू ओपन इट. दिस वी आर चेकिंग ऑर्बिकुलरिस ओक्यूलाई. वील ऑब्जर्व फॉर द नेसोलेबियल फोल्ड. ठीक है, इट विल बी ऑब्लिटरेटेड ऑन द पैरालाइज साइड. And when the child eats or talks, we'll look for the deviation of the angle of mouth. And we ask the patient to blow the air to like this, and we'll try to poke it. This is how we are checking the buccinator muscle. So, सारे जो मोटर फंक्शन हैं ऑफ द फेस दैट इज सप्लाइड बाय द फेशियल नर्व. राइट साइड की राइट साइड ऑफ द फेशियल नर्व होती है, लेफ्ट साइड की लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द फेशियल नर्व होती है. वन मोर थिंग, अपर पार्ट ऑफ द फेस इज सप्लाइड हैज डुअल इनर्वेशन लाइक, बट लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द फेस हैज इनर्वेशन फ्रॉम द सेम साइड नर्व ओनली. सेंसरी क्या होती है? टेस्ट फॉर इंटीरियर टू थर्ड ऑफ द टंग. अगर इंटीरियर टू थर्ड ऑफ द टंग से आपको टेस्ट नहीं फील हो रहा तो दैट मीन्स देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम विद योर फेशियल नर्व. लोअर मोटर न्यूरॉन लीजन ऑफ द सेवेंथ नर्व, इट रिजल्ट्स इन कंप्लीट लैक ऑफ इप्सिलेटरल फेशियल मूवमेंट. उस साइड की मूवमेंट का कंप्लीटली ऑब्लिटरेटेड हो जाएगी. अपर मोटर न्यूरॉन लीजन होगा तो ओनली लोअर हाफ ऑफ द फेस इज अफेक्टेड. अपर पार्ट फंक्शन विल रिमेन इंटैक्ट. क्यों? प्रोबेबली बिकॉज अभी हमने कहा था कि इट हैज डुअल इनर्वेशन. अपर मोटर न्यूरॉन हुआ है तो दैट मीन्स उधर का प्रॉब्लम है, ब्रेन का सेरिबुलर प्रॉब्लम है, बट अपर पार्ट ऑफ द फेस हैज बीन इनर्वेटेड फ्रॉम लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द नर्व. तो दिस इज हाउ अभी हमने ये सारा कर लिया है. ये फ्रंटालिस चेक कर रहे हैं, ऑर्बिकुलरिस ओक्यूलाई चेक कर रहे हैं. यस, अगेन वी आस्क द पेशेंट टू शो द टीथ. इसमें जो है नेसोलेबियल फोल्ड इफ दे आर एब्सेंट सो दैट विल गेट प्रोमिनेंट एंड द जॉ विल डेविएट एंड दिस इज हाउ वी चेक बक्सिनेटर. Then eighth nerve is the vestibulocochlear nerve. The main function is sound perception and maintenance of the body balance. Hearing assessment, we ask for the tinnitus as formal assessment of the hearing. Then there are some crude tests. We can do the Rinne's test. We can do the Weber's test. Audiometry is the main test that we do from 3 years onwards to assess for the hearing functions. In infants, how do we assess? We assess for the blinking of eyes, sudden change of cessation of activity, change in the heart rate, a turning of heads towards the sound of stimulus, a bell or whistle. Sometimes, how do we check it? If the child is crying and we ring a bell, the child transiently stops crying, or the child moves the head towards the sound of the voice. That means the hearing is intact. That is just a crude idea of checking the hearing of the patient. Achha, this is how we check the Rinis. Rinis may, what we do, we put a tuning fork. It is based on the principle that air conduction is better than the bone conduction. We put a vibrating tuning fork on the mastoid process, and when the patient stops hearing it there, we put it in front of the external auditory canal. The Rinis positive is the patient should be able to hear better through the external auditory canal and the vibrating tuning fork, because air conduction should be better than the bone conduction. Then this is the Weber test. We put a tuning fork on the vertex or on the forehead, and it should be equal on both the ears. So this is if the normal Weber is the Weber, we say Weber is centralized. Agar Weber is centralized nahi hai, so that means ki there is some problem in either there is bone problem, conducting problem, or there is sensory neural problem. Just speech. Sorry, I had to take that call. So this is how we check the Weber. Weber is central, means if both the ears, when you are putting the tuning fork here, both the ears should hear simultaneously. And if one, it is lateralized to one ear, that means that child needs formal assessment of the hearing. The vestibular nerve, what is the main function of the vestibular nerve? It helps in the balance of the patient. If it is damaged, then the patient may present with vertigo, giddiness, or dizziness. Caloric test, not done. Caloric test, although not done very commonly, but this is for theoretical purpose, so we can omit it. Now the 9th and the 10th frame, 10th nerves, glossopharyngeal and the vagus nerve. The main function, again, they both are tested together. The main function of the 9th nerve is motor to the stylopharyngeus muscle and middle pharyngeal sphincter. Okay, sensory to the posterior 1/3 of the tongue. Anterior 1/3, anterior 2/3 of the tongue is kaun si nerve supply kar rahi thi? Remember? Go back and see it yourself. So glossopharyngeal kya karti hai? It is motor. Again, it is a mixed form of the nerve. It is motor for the stylopharyngeus muscle and sensory to the posterior 1/3 of the tongue. And we check the gag reflex. 9th and 10th are checked simultaneously. Why? Because posterior pharyngeal muscles ko dono supply karte hain. What we do in the gag reflex, ask the patient to open the mouth. We touch the posterior pharyngeal wall with a cotton stick. And there will be contraction and elevation of the pharyngeal wall on that side. Okay? And its afferent is through 9th and efferent is through 10th. So, if 9th or 10th mein se koi bhi damage hogi, gag will be impaired. 10th nerve, it is motor for the soft palate, pharynx and larynx. Again, 10th also has a parasympathetic supply for respiratory passage, heart, and most of the abdominal viscera. If it is damaged, then nasal regurgitation of the fluids and nasal twang of the voice would be there. Position of the uvula, it moves to normal size in 10th nerve palace. So what happens, 9th and 10th nerve, agar damaged hogi, so what happens when we are swallowing anything, so the passage, the nasopharynx transiently get closed due to contraction of the pharyngeal muscles, the posterior pharyngeal muscles. So hoga kya? Okay, if it is damaged, either 9th or 10th, the pharyngeal muscles or uvula will not work properly, nasopharynx will not be blocked, or the food hai, wo bajaye iske ke oropharynx se hota hua, wo aapke esophagus mein jaye, it can regurgitate and come back towards your mouth. From the nose. Okay, awesome. What happens to the palatal movement? If if the 9th and 10th nerves are damaged, so no movement on the affected side. Again, it will be pulled to the normal side. The uvula would be deviated. And palate will be इमोबाइल इफ बाइलेटरल पैलेटल पेल्सी अगर होगी तो. तो दिस इज हाउ वी चेक द गैग रिफ्लेक्स. वी आस्क द पेशेंट टू से आ, जब अब आ कहेगा तो चीज आप 9th 10th का कैसे चेक करते हो, एक तो यूवुला शुड बी सेंट्रल, ठीक है, अदरवाइज अगर वो डैमेज हो गया पैलेटल मसल्स तो इट शुड बी डिविएटेड. देन वी टच इट थ्रू अ कॉटन स्वाब. तो आपने देखा जब आपने जहाँ पे टच किया तो इट इज कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड मूव अपवर्ड्स. Next is the 11th is the accessory nerves. It supplies the trapezius muscle. And आप check कैसे करते हो? Tested by shoulder shrugging. We ask the patient to shrug the shoulders. पहले खुद ही check करेंगे, like active movement, then we check the passive movement against the wrist. And before that, you'll observe it. If there is dropping of shoulder on the paralyzed side, then scapula drop to the lower level. जिस side की trapezius muscle या accessory nerve damage होगी, उस side का जो shoulder है और scapula है, वो थोड़ा lower side पे होगा. ये this is how we check. And this is we check the second muscle that is supplies is this sternocleidomastoid muscle, ये वाला muscle ना. तो we put it put the hair and ask the patient to move the neck against the resistance. ठीक है, तो दो muscle supply करती है, it is motor now. Trapezius now muscle and sternocleidomastoid muscles को. We ask this patient to turn his head to one side or other against the resistance. Then last one is the hypoglossal nerve. It has the motor function to intrinsic muscles of the tongue. We ask the patient to protrude the tongue and it deviates to the paralyzed side. Okay, now there are again two types of palsies, lower motor neuron palsy or upper motor neuron palsy. Lower motor neuron palsy mein kya hoga? There would be fasciculation with an atrophy of the tongue on affected side. Upper motor neuron palsy mein kya hoga? Tongue spastic hogi, thin hogi and pointed hogi. This will be observed. It's picked up by just observing the patient. ठीक है, ask the patient to protrude. जिस side की weakness होगी उसके against वो protrude कर जाएगी. तो with this we come to the end of our session. Again this is just crude. This is just the basic information. This cannot be the alternate of proper examination. So I hope everything is clear. Go back, read in your books, and we can discuss whatever any queries in our any of our next class. Okay. So I'm stop sharing it the screen, and okay. Wish you good luck.